Dear friends, welcome back. We have been learning the segmentation and the thresholding techniques as well in the previous sessions. I hope they are useful and you are able to understand some content. In this session, we will clearly understand what exactly is region-based segmentation, and we will also discuss one of the techniques called as region growing method under the region-based segmentation. It's very easy, and we will go ahead with the next session also, which is on region-based segmentation, and this is the first session under the criteria. We'll go ahead with the learning, and I hope you will like the session. The region-based segmentation methods clearly segments the image into various regions which are having similar characteristics. I have a very big image, say I have a huge image, or I have an input image for that matter. I'll now identify which of these regions in that image are similar. I will segment them together. That's all. A region is nothing but a group of connected pixels with similar property. I will identify what are the similar properties which are available on the image, and I'll see if the regions can be connected together, and I will go ahead with connecting them as a region. A region is nothing but a group of connected pixels which share similar properties. The similar properties could be in terms of texture, in terms of intensity, in terms of color, in terms of anything. So I need to go ahead with identifying if two sections in an image share similar property such that they can be grouped as a region. There are two techniques that we can go ahead under this segmentation technique, and the first one is called region growing, and the second one is called region split and merge techniques. Since we cannot do both in one session, I'm going to take it up one at a time. We are going ahead with the region growing technique right now, and we are going to learn that. Well, what is our motto? Our motto is very simple. It's all about grouping the pixels or subregions into a larger region based on some predefined criteria. The predefined criteria is nothing but the features or the characteristics that they share in common. This is the simplest of the techniques that somebody can understand. There is a point called the seed point, and we need to identify what is the seed point, and from the seed point the growth will happen. The growth will be governed by adding or appending each of those pixels which are nearby or which are called as the neighboring pixels which share the common properties, and I will add that to the seed point. I have a seed point. I'll now see if the neighboring pixel is sharing the same point, same features as the seed point. I'll now append. I'll go ahead further. I'll grow it further. I'll see if the next pixel is sharing the same features. If yes, I'll add it. I'll keep on adding like that. I'll keep on growing like that. And that's what is called as region growing method. Very simple. The similarities that I look for could be texture or color or shape. The region growing approach is fundamentally based on similarities. Remember, I check for similarities in terms of texture, color or shape. But edge-based techniques are totally different. They are based on dissimilarities. Only when you go with the edge-based techniques, I will identify the objects based on dissimilarities. But here, I will group things based on similarities, and that's the major difference that you need to understand between the region-based techniques and edge-based techniques. The region growing methods are much preferred over edge-based techniques when it comes to noisy images, because in the noisy images, it would not be an easy task for anybody to identify the edges. The noise would trouble you in terms of identifying the edges. So in that cases, it's pretty easy for you to go ahead with the region growing methods. Well, we are going to examine the neighboring pixels. We will see if the neighboring pixels are sharing the same features and the characteristics as I do. In case I get the same features found in the neighboring pixel, I will get it into my region. And this is an iterative process until there is a discontinuity identified. I'll keep doing it as an iterative process, and I'll go ahead with it. So what is the algorithm? Very simple. I will start with set of seed points. Then the similarity check will be carried out with the pixel that I want to check. And if the similarity is as per the expectation, as per the threshold set, I'll add it into my region. I'll keep moving. That's all. I'll keep iterating until the discontinuity is identified. Let's take a very simple example, and we are going to see with the flow. I've got some input image here as a matrix, and this is to undergo the region growing process. I'm identifying a seed. The seed identified here is 1, and I have circled it. Now, what is the next step? As I told you, we need to get the threshold identified. The criteria, I mean the threshold set is 3. The threshold set is 3. I need to identify the boxes, I mean the the cells which have got the value which are less than or equal to 3. So what will I do? I'll keep going ahead with each of these individual cells and I'll start identifying which of them are less than or equal to 3. I identify that these are the region, these are the cells which are less than or equal to 3 and these are above them. So this is region 1 and this is region 2. That's it. I'll compare now each of this cell with this one and I'll start comparing. The comparison keeps happening here and the threshold is met and then I'll call it as region 1. The threshold is not met and I'll call it as region 2. So there is a lot of discontinuity here. 1 is not similar to 5 and there is a definite variation in the intensity. So this is the discontinuity and this is how I can grow. The final region representation can happen here like this. This is region A and this is region B. There is a mistake here. This is region A and this is region B and this is how I can grow it. This is called the region growing technique and this is very easy for you to understand. In case you have any questions, please go ahead and type it in the comment sections. I'll be happy to answer. If you like the channel and the content, please subscribe. Thank you.